was climbing in the lakes the other weekend with Barbara and Eric. We were staying at Wasdale Head, and on our first day we did a practice climb on Ling Mel. I was leading, and Eric was climbing second. And last on the rope was Barbara. She's a newcomer to climbing, but she was thoroughly enjoying herself. Eric suggested that tomorrow we should do a climb on Great Gable. So on Sunday morning we set off from Wasdale. We thought we might try Arrowhead, one of the Nate's ridges. It's a steep scramble to the foot of the climbs, 2,000 feet up on the south face of Gable. Arrowhead is the third ridge from the right. We decided we'd do Arrowhead Ridge direct, a climb classified in the guidebook as B-Div. It looks exposed, but there are plenty of good holds, and we thought Barbara could manage it all right. The most difficult move comes at the start of the second pitch. This is a Tarbuck knot. It's a difficult knot for beginners. There are so many ways of getting it wrong. It's used for fastening the climbing rope to your own waistband, using a carabiner. Eric had tied one in the other end of the rope for Barbara. And a middleman's knot for himself. So, when Eric was ready, I started off. The first pitch is quite easy, with plenty of good holds. There's a good stance at the top of the pitch and an excellent rock for a belay. As soon as I've made the belay secure, I shouted to Eric that I was taking in the slack. And then it was Eric's turn. As soon as Eric had secured himself, I took off my belay and started up the second pitch. The next move looked a bit of a problem. There seemed to be no good holds within reach. At last it was Barbara's turn to start. She did the first pitch without much difficulty, safeguarded by the rope. Eric, with his long reach, had no trouble with the difficult move. Now I was on the third pitch, which leads up to the Arrowhead rock itself. It's not really a difficult pitch, but it is rather exposed. I stepped up onto the arrow and belayed. And there's a more comfortable stance on the other side. Pull on the rope from Eric, and Barbara was up. And then Eric soon joined me on the arrow. There wasn't room for both of us on top, so Eric climbed down behind the arrow to find a better stance. In order to safeguard Barbara when she climbed up to the Arrow, I fixed a running belay over the top. And put her rope into the carabiner before I went on. Eric called to Barbara to come on. The Arrow itself was a bit too difficult for Barbara, so she climbed across below it. And Eric recovered the sling and carrot before following me up the next pitch. Now the climbing was easier along the upper part of the ridge. The rock was warm in the afternoon sun. There didn't seem to be any hurry to finish the climb. I sat down and waited for the others to join me. It was time we were pressing on. There was just one more little problem, the strid. Everyone has their own way of doing it. Barbara needed just a little encouragement. The last pitch is just an easy scramble, and we all climb together. The climb was over. And we unroped before setting off for the summit. It's only another few hundred feet to the top. Behind us, across the valley, were Scarfell and Scarfell Pike. Soon we were on the flat top of Gable, with the summit cairn ahead of us. See Crummock Water, with the Solway Firth and the Scottish Hills in the far distance. Grassmore and the Buttermere Bells. The Langdale Pikes. And Sprinkling Tarn, with the path from Styhead Pass up to S4s. The wind was cold, and we sheltered behind the cairn. But we weren't tempted to stay for long.